Welcome back, fans, to WCW Saturday Night. And you look at our capacity crowd on hand for this big event. How you like that sign?
Yeah. I hear you.
There was a sign from an NWO fan saying Hulk Hogan, Hollywood Hulk Hogan rules. And you talked about Hogan still out making a movie, we understand, but there is no denying he is still the heavyweight champion of the world.
Yeah.
And though Luger's got the title shot, Luger not 100%.
Yeah.
We'll see Luger on Monday at WCW Monday Nitro.
Yeah, and I guarantee you that Hollywood Hulk Hogan is pulling the strings, the power of Hogan still in charge of the NWO. They try to work their way back after Flamboree.
Speaking of WCW Monday Nitro, do not forget that we are back on the air at our regular starting time, 7:55 p.m. It is 2 hours. It is live from Nashville, Tennessee, this coming Monday. Nitro returns at its regular time. And earlier in the telecast, we congratulated this man. We were talking about Hogan, the world heavyweight champion. For the fourth time in his career, Lord Steven Regal is the television champ. And he's the type of champion that knows so many maneuvers, much like a Dean Malenko, and so many holds that it's going to be tough to get this belt away from him.
Yeah, you know, he understands the importance of wearing the gold, especially the television belt. We talked a lot about it, me, you, Mike, today, and the brain in situations where you're sitting down at Slamboree talking about what it takes, because maybe more than any other athlete in WCW, you defend this title. You're seen more with it. It's very prestigious, and it's very hard to hold on to, but this man can. A mat wrestler against a man who's had his ups and downs. Pittman has been on the verge of greatness, and he's been on the verge of bottoming him out. Somewhere in between, he finds himself now. A victory here might put him back on the right road.
Regal having as many problems with the fans as he has
had
before.
He's on the NWA guy. NWO. Look at me, NWA. Well, I was there for many years. The NWO.
He really is, and that's what he's on. And, you know, at Slamboree, if you'll recall, the fans were really behind Regal. I mean, they were really cheering him, and I think it's out of respect. Because
they just hate the guy you're in there with bad that they're just for the grandma they had to.
Well, you know, and here's another fact. It was a big night for WCW and for tradition. And the fans in Charlotte are traditional fans.
Yes.
They're, as we say, old-time, old-school fans.
Yeah.
And Regal's much like that. He is, you know, he was bred under the tradition of the sport and came here from Blackpool, England, has made quite a name for himself, uses holds instead of trying to use gang warfare as a one count after the three-quarter Nelson takeover.
We've seen him as a good fist fight, so, but your analogy of him is right. But this is going to be a hard man to beat right now on the road that he's on and going ahead and taking this world television title away from him. And like I say, Pittman is still learning his trade, been on the verge of doing some good things, but also been down rock bottom. So this is a very important matchup for him on Saturday night. Nitro back to 2 hours regular time. We're back to 2 hours here on Saturday night. Just coming off a great pay-per-view, going into a greater pay-per-view, the Great American Bash, Savage Cage 2. What a matchup. Fight was a brewing. And I guarantee between now and then, there will be a lot more laundry drug in the street with that thing.
You know, we must say this. Honestly, when you look at both men, what has happened between the two, starting the spring stampede when they had that brutal first matchup, until now, both men are not 100%, so they may be even less so when they get to Moline, Illinois on the 15th of June.
Yeah, there'll be a lot more stuff happening, but they mirror each other. When I say, got him, maybe. Teams match up well because they're a lot alike, and they look a lot alike. If you look in the mirror, that's what I mean by mirror image. These two guys here, you know, Savage in the 80s, Page in the 90s. I mean, there's so much alike with the attitudes and everything. So, something got to give somewhere.
No question about it. Whoa. And no, head first. Pittman tried that battering ram maneuver of his, but Regal, who is a consummate wrestler, also showing he is very quick as well. Here's the Irish whip to the right side. Ducked his head, enabling Pittman to go over the top. Regal.
Got him.
No, Pittman won.
Upset. Oh.
Regal hooked the ropes. One, two, three. Regal wins it. Regal wins the match. How about it?
Well, I tell you what, that was closer than the eye would behold.
That's
even a statement.
That four does not mean four horsemen. It means four times world television champ. Yes, we know what
oh,
that means.
Oh, wait a minute. Are you sure about that?
Yes.
That's been ruined. Well, I won't say him.
Oh, you're starting some stuff.
No,
again.
I won't say him, but you're right. For now, let's say that four means four times world heavyweight champion.
World television champ.
World's television champion.
Which is also...
You got I got on you a while ago, yes. And you come back on me. That's good.
All right,
let's go. People can't expect me to sound like that.
Let's go to Lee Marshall.
Guys, thanks very much. It was a couple of weeks ago, Stephen Regal asked us not to refer to him by any title of nobility, but I'm afraid that we do have to refer to him as champion. Once again, you do indeed walk the walk and talk the talk.
When I say I'm going to do something, I deliver the goods. Now, people are asking me, why have I dropped his lordship from my title? Mm-hmm. I was sick and tired of the embarrassment of being associated with the noble people and the royalty in England. It was just too much for me. After I saw that bloody Fergie, the Duchess of York, hawking bloody cranberry juice to you idiots for you to buy, it just, that was it. Enough is enough.
You had a problem with her hugging Tiger Woods, I suppose.
Do you know, it used to be the Duke of York that had 10,000 men. Now it's the bloody Duchess. Now, Sergeant Craig Pittman, Marine champion, how many times over? Hundreds. World champion, in fact. Didn't take me very long to beat him, did it? You can take Dean Malenko, you can take Diamond Dallas Page, take Steve Mungo McMichael, take Ric Flair, now he's back. They're still not in my league. Now, the WCW world title, I never get a chance of that, do I?
No.
Because of politics and nonsense. The US title, why would I want to be the champion of you pathetic, woeful Americans? This is where I belong. This is my home, and this is where I'm going to stay. This belt will stay with me until I bloody retire it this time, and you can keep watching to watch the best wrestler in the world.
Unprecedented four-time champion, world television champion, Stephen Regal. We've got more action coming up on a Saturday night, right after this.
I erased a difference in philosophy with the big boys from the NWO. I was able, by the grace of the good Lord,